And we are in game. So we see both teams spreading out, and today playing for Waynesburg, we have T22 playing top on the Cho'Gath. Out of the jungle, we will have Invochi on Jarvan the Fourth. In mid, we have Sinus Moon on the Lissandra. Bottom carry tonight will be Quackies. Oh my gosh, on the Caitlyn. And we have Mercy Penguin on the Yuumi. For Ohio Wesleyan Onyx, we have playing top, we have Phoenix on the Scion. We have Nocturne. We have a feudal thing coming out of the jungle with Nocturne. We have King Kong Chrono mid with, I think it was Sylas. And we see the junglers getting started on their camps with some help. And we see both bottom pairs headed to get started on their lane. See, for Waynesburg, the poking has started. Mercy Penguin taking an aggressive position in this forward bush. See the Jarvan the Fourth clearing up his bottom jungle and heading towards the top jungle. Some trades from Scion and Cho'Gath. First couple minutes, we see Cho'Gath having some trouble farming top. Scion with 15 CS to his 3. Other than that, the lanes seem pretty even. And even then, 10 CS is not that big of a deal. Fortunately, the lane is pushing in towards Cho'Gath, going to make it easier for him to farm, as long as he isn't contested by the tower. And man, we see bottom. Mommy Nami taking a bunch of damage from Quackies. Creech is now having to tank some under tower. Quackies really good at these kind of poking in lane. Often gets a lot of work done here early. Not just farming well, but getting a lot of damage on the bottom support and carry. Sinus Moon able to get some decent damage, but takes some hits in response as the Sylas tries to even up the damage numbers. Ooh. Ah. Caitlyn not quite able to land that hit. And we see Cho'Gath getting some good damage on Scion. He's at about half. Ooh, Jarvan really wants that pick. He's gonna have to flash over the wall to get away from Nocturne responding. But that's gonna let the mid Sylas know that he can go in on Lissandra, and he's with the Ignite, he's able to get the kill. Also lets Cho'Gath and Scion know that they're gonna be alone for a while with both junglers bottom. So they're kind of on their own. We expect Cho'Gath to pick up some good CS here under tower. Here, Quackies just pushing the lane in. Force the support back. trying to take as much advantage of that as he can. See, Cho'Gath still about 15 CS behind, but he's staying there, so not falling too far behind. Sylas doing a little bit better mid, especially with that kill, gives him a little bit of help. Caitlyn, a couple more CS, but so far it's just very even.
As expected.
Only about a 500 gold difference, which is not really a big deal. The Silas going in on Silas Moon again. Doesn't have Ignite, having used it already, but gets Silas Moon really low. But that, yeah, that's the Silas ult. And Nocturne has moved mid, and Silas is moving towards bottom. Interesting to see if they can get anything done versus the Caitlyn.
Not so close.
Well, and we see Silas is now coming back with the Nocturne. Oh, they're gonna head back. Nocturne back to the blue buff, Silas back to mid. See Sion in the river, just picking up some, taking out that wandering river creep. Gives them a little bit of vision around Rift Herald. And we see Cho'Gath walking back to lane. Caitlyn's gonna go back and buy. Able to pick up a decent amount of damage and boots. Hopefully that helps her get some kills. Cho'Gath fighting his turret for CS. Doing a good job of it. Ooh, we see Silas. Good call from Sinus Moon, pinging that out. Cho'Gath, yeah, we see him back away from the wave. Great move. Not letting himself get ganked. Ooh, we see Lissandra getting ganked. Getting grabbed by the Silas, hit by the Nocturne, but with the turret support and the Jarvan just across the wall, she should be fine. So this move re-engaged and gets taken out by the Silas. Caitlyn continuing to farm well. And we see the Sion really doing really well top. Cho'Gath able to keep his HP relatively low. Whoa. Sion going in under. Fortunately, no pop-up for Cho'Gath. He's able to get out of it. Ooh, with the Jarvan coming in, though. The Nocturne ult is going to be able to jump in on Cho'Gath. Should be able to get a kill here. Oh, no, Jarvan ults. Oh, my gosh. Just action going everywhere. Ooh. Jarvan breaks a TP. Breaks a TP again. They're going to go in on him. Syndra's nearby. The Nocturne has TP'd out. Okay, Waynesburg's just going to send the Cho'Gath and Jarvan back. And everybody's going to kind of reset.
Now you're ready to prowl.
Ooh, Clacky's going to take a hit from tower. And Silas just going to get back to the act of farming up his lane. Ooh.
As expected.
Clacky's able to take a nice plate. Waynesburg down about 1,000k. Less that turret plating that just got taken. But that's not a... That is not that big of a deal. But it is something. See bottom lane kind of going back to buy again. See more damage coming out for Caitlyn. A nice 20 CS lead there. Only a 10 CS lead for the Silas mid. Cho'Gath takes a substantial amount of damage from the Scion. Nocturne in river. I don't know if that was spotted out or just for another reason. But Lissandra's going to get dove under tower. So this rune is up to the task. Rift Herald's going to get dropped on that mid turret. See Cho'Gath and Scion continuing to go at it. Scion actually just behind the tower, causing all manner of trouble. And looks like with Quackies and Jarvan here, they're going to go get started on Dragon. They have pretty good vision on the other side, yeah. So they're ready for this engage. Jarvan immediately ults. He's going to go down. Quackies not able to get any kills. Lissandra's gonna get feared up and taken out by the Nocturne. And Quacky's maybe able to get a runaway kill on the Silas, but not quite. Quacky's just gonna have to run out of here. Oh. Just not quite enough damage from Quacky's in that fight to get any kills. Some. Great, really good positioning from everybody, but the damage just wasn't there. Scion once again under tower, just doing his thing. Jarvan picking up a red buff. Scion just burning down the wave behind the tower. Just not quite able to freeze the. Lissandra, Sinus Moon in mid, not quite able to freeze the Silas under tower. But Jarvan with both buffs. Let's use a round Rift Herald. Let's see which direction he's going to go. Getting pinged out by Ohio Wesleyan. Just misses the pop. pop up from the Cho'Gath. Cho'Gath getting dive in on Caitlyn with the Nocturne. She's gonna go down. Mercy Penguin's probably gonna go down too. It's an awful lot of damage. Wesley now up to a 4k gold lead. Starting to get substantial. Significant damage done to the turret top as well. Ooh. Sion takes a ton of damage top from the Cho'Gath. Cho'Gath starting to get in a position where he will no longer be bullied by this Sion, but still not quite in a good enough position to get the kill. Oh man, Phoenix very aggressive with that slash, almost gets picked up by Cho'Gath, but he's able to get back to tower. Cho'Gath went back, Sion also just headed back. This Nocturne actually taking a little bit of a lead over Invoci out of the jungle. Caitlyn is the bright spot here with her almost 30 gold lead, or 30, excuse me, 30 CS lead on bottom. See top turret go down to the Sion, and surprising and taking a ton of damage, and Sion's gonna unstoppable away from the Jarvan and Cho'Gath. That's just gonna give him a ton more space. Ooh, Quacky's almost able to get the kill, but Creech's tanks, ooh, just barely not enough to take down both the Soraka and the AD carry. Oh my gosh. Caitlyn headed towards Dragon, sees that it's down, gets caught up by the Nocturne R. Caitlyn picking up a Kraken Slayer. And Sion's gonna break down the top tower, the mid tier one. And we'll probably take down the bottom tier one here shortly as well. And there it goes. See a big fight here mid. They try to take down the Sylas. And Voci gets ignited, has to jump out. They just cannot get enough damage onto him. Especially not with the Sion there. With us hitting the 20-minute mark, Baron Nashor is now going to spawn top half of the river. See top jungle just getting stolen by Ohio Wesleyan. Trogath, a nice silence. Ooh, a nice pop-up. Gonna land on that silence. With his shield and what? Almost 4,000 HP, he'll be fine. But bottom turret gonna go down for bottom tier one gonna go down. It's good news for Waynesburg. Caitlyn gonna back. And sweeping around the bottom jungle, cleaning up a ward, placing his own. Vochi gonna clear up a ward around mid as Caitlyn shows up. Nocturne behind them. They see him, he's gonna ult the Caitlyn. He's gonna set up his sphere. She's gonna go down. Can't handle him along with the rest of his team showing up. See Ohio Wesley and Onyx team just looking to take over this game here. Just a ton of wards on the blue side of the map, giving them a ton of vision control. We see that Silas pushing out bottom. Jarvan gonna have to fight the Silas for his own one of his own camps. Trogath trying to protect this turret, but you see the Scion, just one big cleaver hit is enough to take off about a quarter of its HP. Means we're really going to have to protect Quackies here. This Caitlyn's going to be crucial for taking down these very well-off tanks and carries from Ohio Wesleyan. Ooh, Nocturne. Hit behind bottom tier two, but it goes down to the rest of his team. Cho'Gath, feared in the middle of the enemy team. Getting taken out. Nocturne jumps in on Caitlyn, takes her out. And they're going to push in on this tier three. You've seen just a couple hits. Okay. With the group we've cleared up, they're not interested in taking much turret damage. Winsberg still looking to move and fight around this mid lane. Okay, we see some spreading out. Caitlyn and it looks like Cho'Gath both going bottom. Wesson's gonna back up and take their third dragon. Jarvan dropping down a ward. Ooh, not able to pop up the Silas. They crossed over each other in a way that was very detrimental for Invoci and unfortunate. Sorry about that, we're not on full screen. My goodness. Directed camera, please. Little Scion gonna jump in on the drive-in. Nocturne comes to join him. He's able to get away. Burns his flash. Cho'Gath is here, but he's tanky, but he's not able to take on Nocturne and Scion tanky. Good pop-up, though. Will he get some damage on them with his spikes? Greensburg down 8k. Ooh, and here's the damage we needed to see. Galen trying to get set up. Yes, with Jarvan in here. Oh, he burns his flash. But with the Jarvan ult, they should be able to take up both of these characters. Caitlyn ults for it. And that's a double kill for Quackies. That's a nice 400 gold shutdown. Ooh, Nocturne over here finds Cho'Gath. Ooh, Waynesburg wants to fight. They know they just got some kills. Nocturne's gonna hold in. Ooh, and we see this. The damage we needed to see from Waynesburg is he's coming out. Sion's gonna get popped up. And we see the tanks from Waynesburg doing a great job body blocking for their carries. Oh, Quacky, another shutdown. Yumi actually gets the kill, excuse me. I do not understand how Invoci survived there. This is wild. He's so sneaky. And we see the Sion coming back. And dead. Nocturne is gonna have to run away. And this was a remarkably successful fight from Waynesburg. Showing just what they can do when the tanks are able to body block for their carries. Ooh. Oh, and here we're about to see what happens when Caitlyn gets jumped on. Able to get away with the net. Gonna put a decent amount of damage on this Nocturne. And it's gonna potentially precipitate a fight as both teams are responding to this. Ah, Cho'Gath just missing Soraka with his pop-up. Waynesburg back to within 6k, down from an 8k gold deficit. It's a substantial comeback. It'll be interesting to see if there's a Baron fight here. If Waynesburg is able to get a similarly successful fight as what they just had in front of their base, that could be a big turnaround for them. We're doing a good job of clearing out all these aggressive wards, reclaiming their jungle vision. Mid getting pushed in. Sion kind of hanging out in that top jungle. He's going to head over in the direction of Baron, but it's unclear if they're going to. Oh, looks like they're going to start in. I don't know if they saw the Jarvan TP out, but this is a great time for this. Waynesburg might have time to contest. Nocturne's gonna ult. Kind of messing up the Waynesburg vision. And that's gonna be Baron. But Waynesburg is gonna be here and they're able to get a kill to start off with. It looked like Lissandra was gonna go down there, but she lives. They take out three. Unfortunately, the Caitlyn goes down, and Yumi Cho'Gath not able to deal with both Sion and Sylas together. But with the defense of the turrets, they're able to survive. 3v3 trade there. And that also means there's only a couple characters with Baron buff. One of the advantages to taking Baron is, of course, you get a buff that gives you a bunch of stats, regen and such. And when you die, you lose that buff. Waynesburg looking like they want to contest the next dragon. Which is a good decision because this, if it's taken by Ohio Wesleyan, this will be their fourth dragon. Ohio Wesleyan coalescing around the area, ready to go. Looks like they're going to be ready to get this one started. potentially they really want to pick. They've pulled the dragon forward out of the pit. And Waynesburg's going to have to come around or over this wall if they want to contest. It's looking like they're not going to be in time to contest. Dragon takes a bunch of damage and goes down. And Waynesburg's just going to back towards mid. Resume the farming that they need. Jarvan gets jumped on by the Nacho and takes a ton of damage. Cho'Gath able to take down the turret mid, backed up by his team. Jarvan going super low, but Invoci's able to get away. The bottom tier 2 for Waynesburg goes down, taken out. There's a big fight top, or mid, excuse me. Silas goes down. That Scion, though, is now on Quackies, and Quackies is going to have some trouble here. Has to get away. Quackies goes down, and that's a big problem for Waynesburg. Only the Jarvan up for Waynesburg, and only the Silas down for Ohio Wesleyan. Nocturne jumps in on the Jarvan. He's going to fear him off. They're going to take this first inhibitor.
Blue team's inhibitor has been destroyed.
Ooh, Scion unstoppableing into these turrets. These tier 4 turrets are going to take a ton of damage super quickly. They're already gone. Wings were going to have to fight as people are up. They're getting a ton of damage done, but the not enough to protect the Nexus. The Nexus goes down, and Ohio Wesleyan is going to take game one. This is a best of three, and we will head over to the next match, or the next game in this match. We will head over to the draft as soon as both teams are ready. I'm going to put that up for you, and then once they are in the game, we will join them. And we are in with game two. In game one, we saw Ohio Wesleyan University Onyx team take that one. And so we are looking for Waynesburg to equalize here in game two. D-Wheels has subbed in for T22. And so for Waynesburg, we have Mercy Penguin top on this Yorick. We have Invoci out of the jungle on his Vigo. We have Sinus Moon going mid with Vex. Bottom carry, we have Quackies on Vayne. And bottom support, we have D-Wheels on the Thresh. For Ohio Wesleyan, we have Phoenix on their Scion. We have A Feudal Thing on Talon. We have King Kong Chrono on Pantheon in mid. Talon out of the jungle, sorry. We have Creeches back on Nyla. And Mommy Nami. I'm going to call him Mo. On Seraphine. And we see both signs out here taking blue buff. Or taking buffs. Red buff for Invoci. Blue buff for the Talon. And everybody proceeding the lane. Thresh hook, able to get some damage in on creatures, but
die with me, brothers, and be free.
Flash already down bottom. Flash down bottom. Thresh used his Hex Flash. Yeah, his Hex Flash, so they know he has it. Using that Vayne roll to good effect down bottom. Sinus Moon taking some serious damage with the Ignite, may go down, and does. And that's first blood going to the Pantheon. Chrono there doing an excellent job with his early game Ignite management. Understanding just exactly how much damage needs to be done to secure the kill early. Waynesburg pushed pretty far here. Oh man. York getting ganked. Talon's coming in. He's able to dodge most of their damage and back up, but still has to be kind of safe. And we see Vigo identifying Talon and expect York to do really good CSing, staying in with the Scion. You see Pantheon taking a slight lead, probably more significant with that kill. Oh, Thresh with the nice hook. Vayne gets the stun, rolls forward, not able to get the kill with the exhaust, but flashes forward and gets it. Oh, and it looks like D-Wheel's going to be the last one standing bottom as the Vayne goes down. Worthwhile trades for Waynesburg, though. As the gold lead gold is basically tied. And that was a lot of support ults there. And we see Mercy Penguin just throwing these zombies at the Scion. constantly keeping up the pressure, keeping his HP low, not letting him get out of control, while maintaining CS, yeah, taking a CS lead over the Scion. Yeah, everything's very even right now. It'll be an advantage to whoever can get make something happen.
It's good to see you.
Would really like to see Mercy Penguin get the kill on this Scion. But their Scion players does a really good job staying alive. Chrono again jumping on Sinismoon. Getting some damage on, not going for the kill. Oh man, that poke. So strong. Sinismoon gonna have to back off. Yiga's gonna come over and defend her lane for a couple moments. This skin just full of cat noises, apparently. Mercy Penguin still getting lots of nice set of last hits there. Yeah, 10 CS lead. Vayne with a 5 CS lead bottom. And Yorick's gonna back. Going for first buy. Oh, Thresh, please. They're looking for this Vayne. They get in on him. Hook forward. Not able to get Nami in turret range. But able to disable enough to keep the Vayne from getting killed there. And Mercy Penguin. Out here looking to take over this top lane. Oh man, D-Wheel's gonna get dove by 3. He's doing a great job staying in a good defensive position on the backside of his turrets. Good threatening location where if anybody decides to aggress on him with auto attacks, he's ready to land that hook. Lands a hook on the Talon, and Talon goes down to Vayne. A terrible outcome for Ohio Wesley. Great for us, though. You really want Quackies to get farmed up. Mercy Penguin continuing to pressure the Scion. Quackies baits out some CS. D-Wheels takes a bunch of. Gochi is there. That's a flash from Nami and goes down. Quackies is exhausted. See King Kong Chrono jumping in. And Vochi gets a kill. Quacky's low. Chrono's gonna try and get the kill. Doesn't get it. Oh, no. Yeah, goes down. And King Kong Chrono has to back out. Still, Waynesburg staying equal. And stacking up kills on their. On their carry and jungler, which is a good thing. But this Pantheon, 300 gold bounty already, ahead on CS with 3 kills, gonna be a problem moving forward.
Welcome back. You won't be here long.
Scion getting low, top. Quackies and Thresh looking to push aggressively forward. Trying to deny some CS. Lands a hook. Nice Thresh hook. Oh, the charm on Quackies. That's a problem. Rolls not enough to get out of range, and he's going to go down. The Talon is there. Going to jump on D-Wheels, but that's a mistake. Not quite able to get him in range. D-Wheels might go down here. They're going to push into tower and try and get this kill. D-Wheels lands the hook. He's going to go down, but the jungler for Ohio Wesleyan is going to go down. Darvin's still looking for some kills. But against two, there's not a lot he can do. dangerous positioning for him. Mercy Penguin going toe-to-toe with the Scion and a Creep Wave. Hits the kill. Scion going to try and get some farm with his revive, and he goes down. Not a revive, but when Scion dies, he comes back and lives with his HP burning down for a couple seconds longer. Man, things still even. Oh, the blink from the Thresh trying to land that hook. Ooh. Talon and Thresh going toe-to-toe, but Quackies is there, and Talon is going to regret taking that fight. And that's more farm for Quackies, and D-Wheels is just going to D-word this bush. Scion being left alone top for a moment. He's going to catch up to Yorick. And Vochi able to get a 10 CS lead on the Talon. And everything else very even. Sinismoon and Chrono just trying to get some poke on each other, get each other though ready to get killed when somebody rotates around. Mercy Penguin fighting the Scion. Scion always annoying to deal with when he's got full HP. Ooh, a nice hook from D-Wheels putting Nami right next to Quackies. He's gonna take a lot of CC there, but he's able to get away from most of it. D-Wheels, another nice hook. Hitting Mommy Nami. Oh, Quacky's charmed for it. He's probably going to go down here. D-Wheels lands another hook, but there's nobody to follow up. Sinismoon coming back to lane, having backed up to buy and get health. See Mercy Penguin getting, getting attacked by the Talon, but takes a ton of damage, but is able to walk away. Both top and jungler took a ton of damage from that. If Mercy Penguin had been able to focus the damage on the Talon, would have probably killed him. Blue team dropping the Rift Herald on Dragon? Takes the Dragon. Works out very well for the jungler to be, for the opposing jungler being top. You see D-Wheels hugging this wall, looking to get a hook, but nobody nearby. Talon invading the jungle. Please, give me. And just gonna plant a ward and TP out. Brawly game early. Means we're doing an excellent job staying with Ohio Wesleyan. Ohio Wesleyan with about a 400 gold lead. Barely anything. But the difference here, until somebody's able to get some more kills, is just going to be who is able to get their items and, like, just very important hiding timings and such. Mercy Penguin able to put some nice damage on the Scion. So this means getting jumped on next to a turret, but not actually protected. Creatures takes a bunch of damage, Not able to get away from Gwacky's, though. Gwacky's kind of low after that. Talon coming through the Winsberg bottom jungle. We'll see if he's able to jump in and get the kill. Doesn't look like he's not going to go for it. He's going to clear out this ward on Dragon. Where's he Penguin? Going to get some damage on this Sire. Coming out of the bush. He's an unstoppable away. But we'll get a couple zombies, but it'll cost him some CS to back away from the wave here. Bunch of people, the Pantheon, the Talon, everyone jumping on Mercy Penguin. Sion is low. Mercy Penguin wants it. Vucci is going to take some jungle camps. Sinismood's going to wander around the jungle there. Get a little bit of a D ward on her bottom bush. And Yorick's finally getting her back. Sinismune getting ganked. But able to just flash out. Oh, D was a nice grab. Ooh, Wacky's charmed, but able to get the damage. Creatures going in, getting a ton of damage done. With Chrono jumping in, they're able to get two kills for the one. Wacky's almost able to outdo them. But top Sion goes down to Mercy Penguin's constant pressure. And this tower is not long for this world.
Red team's turret has been destroyed.
Oh. As we look, Waynesburg actually has a 400 gold lead, almost a 1,000 gold gold differential swing from when I last talked about the gold. Not an important gold difference at all, but Waynesburg continuing to stay with it. See Waynesburg, everybody coming back down mid. We might see a fight coalesce here. Talon taking his red buff. Vigo going to take this next Rift Herald. It looks like Waynesburg gonna... Ooh, Quacky's getting a lot of damage on the opposing carry. A good like auto attack, roll in auto attack may just kill the opposing carry out with the wage pushing in. He backs up. Mercy Penguin now looking to push down this mid turret. And with everything going on, I did not see if Rift Herald got taken. By who, rather? Sion able to just push in. Ooh, D-Wheel's a great grab. But not a lot of follow-up. Vucci and the Sion going toe-to-toe. This seems ill-advised for Vucci, but has to defend this top tier two. And Dragon getting started, getting almost taken down by Ohio Wesleyan. They take it. It's a Dragon for each. Work. Punishing this Sion as he enters the mid lane. This turret's going to go down. And that's the mid tier one down. That. And it looks like we might see a fight coalesce. Talon's going to ult. He's going to try and take out Sinismune. Sinismune barely goes down.
Killing spree.
But Vigo able to take out the Talon. D-Wheels lands a hook. And he's going to set up a kill. He actually gets the kill. A bunch of CC comes out the Scion, using his undead life to try and survive. D wheels a nice save. Whoa. Weird hook. Quacky's really low, not able to just provide enough damage. Has to back up. This fight continues with Mercy Penguin kind of holding the river and chasing everyone else away. But all those kills and all that fighting in the gold differential is just about even. Both teams doing a great job here. See Waynesburg, most everybody backing, Vex pushing out mid, everybody else returning to their respective lanes more or less. Thresh hanging out in his bottom jungle, looking to support Sinismoon should anybody want to gank her, and trying to set a kill up for her if possible. Quacky's able to get some damage, but actually ends up just taking more damage just from the turret. Then Quacky is able to deal. Thresh coming around. And you have four people from Ohio West in the mid. Creech is able to get Quacky's kind of low, and Bochy and Mercy Penguin are gonna end up down there, and they're gonna take this bottom tier one. Well, mid tier one is probably gonna go down. Three-man push. D-Wheels. A lot of good CC, but the turret goes down. Sinismoon getting it taken out. Not able to get away, but York kind of getting a little out of control. Going to be putting a ton of pressure on this bottom tier two. Oh my goodness. It's almost dead. Is he just going to kill it right here? He is. Bottom tier two just goes down. For nothing. And that's a decent amount of map control for Waynesburg just from that bottom tier 1 and tier 2 down. See? D-Wheels. Aggressively placed, he's gonna run into the Pantheon. Okay, they do not engage. Scion has Invochi and Quackies on him. That's a problem. He's gonna be able to do a ton of damage to Quackies if he can get close enough, but he can't. Quackies, great job using his roll and just general speed to stay out of the way. Bottom tier one's gonna go down for Waynesburg. But that's a big kill, because Mercy Penguin is just going to push out top and threaten this tier 2 very quickly. All the while getting more farm. Bottom tier 2 getting threatened. Sinismoon and Invochi are going to respond to that. And they're looking to catch creatures. But creatures able to get out. As is being pinged out repeatedly, the Drake's about to spawn in the bottom river. And yeah, that tier 2, they let Mercy Penguin push. And he's going to take towers. And more than 1,000 gold lead for the first time for Waynesburg. And they're going to coalesce around Dragon. With Invochi there, they're going to be able to take it. Invochi's and Quackies, they're going to take it very quickly. Thresh doing a good job planting down a ward, using that vision to just zone out Ohio Wesleyan, and that's a second Drake for Waynesburg. Work, pushing out mid, putting pressure on the Scion. Jeez, that was such a strong hit. as we see, Baron is up, but there's a lot of word control around that for Ohio Wesleyan. And blue buff stolen by the Talon. But Bane headed up here. Ooh. Sees the Talon, kind of backs up a little. I expected Quacky's to be more aggressive there. But Talon gets out. Quacky's gonna just farm. And Mercy Penguin's gonna take over this push. And see what kind of response he can force from Ohio Wesleyan. As you look at the CS, York only a 10 gold, 10 CS lead over the Scion. Talon actually with 40 CS. Pantheon with 70. And the bottom bottom carry is about even. When you look at the gold. Oh my goodness. Invoci just jumped on by three. He's gonna go down. Quacky's getting a ton of damage on the Scion. He's gonna go unstoppable, but he's gonna go down. King Chrono is here. They're gonna pick up with the rest of the team responding around back. I guess just the Talon. They're gonna pick up Quacky's and Sinismoon. D Wills lands another good hook, but his team is not there. Meanwhile, Mercy Penguin just left alone to go take out this tier 3, this inhibitor turret. So things are very equal. Ooh, Talon just barely able to get away from that hook. D Wills still wants this hook. He's heading down towards red buff. Gonna take some damage in a slow. To see vision control going down for Ohio Wesleyan around this bottom river. Jewels lands another good hook, but nobody's able to follow up. Hooks the Talon, but once again, nobody's ready to follow up on these hooks. Talon gonna take his blue buff. Creech is gonna push out this bottom wave. Try and keep it away from their tier 3 or inhibitor turret. Scion pushing out top. Drake gonna be spawning in less than a minute. And both teams look like they're gonna wanna be ready to fight this. You see Quackies and Mercy Penguin going back to get items. See the wards getting dewarded. Talon actually taking up an aggressive position here. Looking to get a pickoff. D-Wheels. Doing a good job just zoning off. The Waynesburg bottom jungle. You see, everybody is there from Ohio Wesleyan. Meanwhile, York just pushing out his top, and he's going to take this top inhibitor if they are not careful. Pantheon on Quackies. The dragon's going to go down. Waynesburg going to respond and try and get something done. Um, Sinismoon's gonna go down. This top inhibitor is done. Deagle's gonna take some damage. Not quite gonna land the hook, though. And we see the rest of Mercy Penguin still top. The rest of Ohio Wesleyan here looking to try and pick up D-Wheels and Quackies. But Creech is probably enough to clear out the wave. But if they don't stay under their turrets, yeah, they're going to take a lot of damage from Mercy Penguin. And we see Talon has to come back. With two top, Mercy Penguin's going to have to back away. He traps the Talon, but bottom tier 2 goes down, but Waynesburg now in a 4v3 bottom. Gonna take this engage, and Vochi gets a kill. Mercy Penguin gets killed, gonna go down to the Talon. But that's a 2v1, a 2-for-1 for Waynesburg. They're a little behind in gold, about a 2k gold lead for Ohio Wesleyan. But with their top inhibitor down and a York, it's very dangerous. Waynesburg just pushing up aggressively. They know they forced a bunch of people back. They're going to head towards mid and look to push out this wave and get set up to prevent Ohio Wesleyan from taking Baron. Ohio Wesleyan going to farm, but also probably looking for a straggler from Waynesburg. If they can get a pick here, that'll make taking Baron much easier. D-Wheels in the jungle, jumps into the Baron pit, able to get away. Vochi going to pick up his blue buff. Ohio Wesleyan rotating 3 mid and 2 top. Mercy Penguin going to push out bottom. It's not quite an open inhibitor, but just a tier 3 is basically an open inhibitor for York with how fast he takes down turrets. Futile Thing stealing red buff from Waynesburg yet again. And Vochi going to run into him TPing. Pulls the Talon ult out, but is able to get out without significant damage. Mercy Penguin pushes out top and then TP's away, forcing the rest of Ohio Wesleyan actually rotated bottom. And we see the pings immediately come out from Waynesburg. They want him to go towards Baron. They saw at least 2, maybe 3 bottom. And that's a big deal. Means we're gonna go take Baron right now. This is an excellent call. They just get it for free. Just the pressure that Mercy Penguin puts on the map. Nami just clearing out the Nashor Pit of wards. You see Drake going to be up in about 30 seconds. It's going to be the next big fight. The Ohio Wesleyan top inhibitor should be up again soon. Ooh, Deal is with a nice hook on Chrono. And another nice hook. And Vochi and Quacky's there to the south in the river are very dangerous. Mercy Penguin and Sion gonna go at it top. red top inhibitor is respawned. Wainsworth starting in on dragon. There is vision here. D-Wheels gonna head towards their last position. We see them jump in. They're actually able to smite the Drake away and jump in on Wainsberg. Wainsberg retreating towards the enemy side of the map. D-Wheels goes down first, but he's able to trade his life for the Talon. Quacky's able to do just a tremendous amount of damage. Chrono goes down, and Vochi is on top of the enemy carry. We see a bunch of flashes come out and a shutdown. Mercy Penguin is top, pushing in this top inhibitor. Sion is just trying to wail on him and his creeps. But Mercy Penguin does not care. Able to get the kill, and that's an ace for Waynesburg. Stayed even with Ohio Wesleyan, and we see York immediately moving to these tier fours. And Vochi comes over, he's gonna join in. Sinus Moon is there as well. They're gonna burn down the tier fours and take the Nexus. And that is gonna even up the score. Oh. And that will take it. Waynesburg has tied us 1-1 versus OWU Onyx. And we're going to get into game three. They're going to do the draft, and then we're going to get in with a 3-minute delay again. And so we'll be back with the draft and then the game of game three. And we're back with game three, the deciding game in this best of three match between Waynesburg University and Ohio Wesleyan University's Onyx. We see everybody is in and headed out into the jungle. For Waynesburg, we will be on the red side. In top position, we have Mercy Penguin on the Mordekaiser. Out of the jungle, we have Invoci, once again, on the Vago that we saw him play last game. Subbing in for Sinismoon, we have Sullinator in mid with his Heimerdinger. Bottom, we have Quackies running the carry. Ooh, we see Mercy Penguin getting engaged on by a jungle invade. Has to flash away. Takes a bunch of damage. And they're going to go for this for stealing red buff here. Oh, nope. They're just going to put down a Warden Leaf. Content with the damage dealt to Mercy Penguin. Anyways, in the bottom, we have Quackies on the Draven. And bottom support, we have D-Wheels once again on his Thresh. On the blue side, we have OWU Onyx. We have King Kong Chrono on Pantheon top. Out of the jungle, we have a Feudal Thing on Kane. We see some trading going on top. Mercy Penguin in a little bit of a disadvantaged position from that early damage. Out of the mid for Ohio Wesleyan, we have Phoenix on Annie. Bottom carry, we have Samira, played by Creeches. And bottom support, we have Mommy Nanny playing Zyra. Ooh, see Quacky's getting rooted. But not taking too much punish for that. They want to put some damage on Creeches here. Oop, Orb, Nanny. Burning the flash out. It's good for Waynesburg. Means if D-Wheels can get a good hook, where Quackies can damage outside of turret aggro radius, they're looking at a very potential kill, a very good potential kill on the support. Mercy Penguin already trading up to about even with King Kong Chrono. Gets jumped on, takes a lot of damage. Oh, and gets picked off. Ooh, Phoenix going down really low against the Heimer. And he able to take the ignite and live. Just barely has to back out. Trading pretty effectively, but already about a 500 gold deficit here. Really? Which are gonna get jumped on by the jungler. Smites, gets out. Quackies and D-Wheels continue pushing in, looking for these hooks. Looking for a punish while Nami's flash is down. And Voci gonna take his turn jumping on the enemy jungler. With D-Wheels there, a flash away. D-Wheels might be able to land a hook now. So wait, Quacky's gonna get the kill here on Nanny. Creech's gonna get jumped on by Invoci and D-Wheels. He tries to get Quackies, but Quackies takes him down. Mercy Penguin, a bunch of damage up top. Able to get a lot of work done with that shield, though, but very low. Gonna have to back away from the wave. And that's a problem top. This is Pantheon, very good at managing kill potential, especially early. Oh, almost. Ooh, nice hook from D-Wheels as they look, as Hiawazlin looks to go aggressive. D-Wheels takes a bunch of damage, but a futile thing takes a ton as well. Exhaust, and he gets killed. Creatures on D-Wheels, able to get the Thresh. Mordekaiser goes down to the Pantheon top. And we're going to see Draven, Quackies on Draven, fall here in the bottom lane. Still staying pretty even in gold. There's no longer a 500 gold lead for anyone. Sully, ton of damage mid, but then takes a bunch in return between the Annie and the creeps, pushing his wave under turret. Ooh. Mercy Penguin after that death, coming back to lane, able to take a good HP lead versus this Pantheon. Giving him a lot more room to control the wave. Tully looking to go back and buy. Phoenix very low. Gonna take out some turrets while Heimerdinger's backed off. Directed camera not being the most amazing directed camera ever. Seeing Vochi in a futile thing. Going at it here in Wainsburg's jungle. Thresh doing a good job of just zoning out the enemy carry. Just the threat of that hook is enough to keep them back. Man. Thresh dewarding Tribush. Getting pressured by Nami, but Nami's gonna deward the wards he puts down. It's just a back and forth there. Still taking a lot of damage from the Nami. Mercy Penguin pushing in this wave. Really like to go in and get his shield up and some damage down. D-Wheels goes for the hook, gets a creep. Nami. Taking a couple shots from Quackies. Ooh, with a futile thing coming in, they're going to go all out on D-Wheels. Quackies going to go down first. D-Wheels lands the hook, but it's too late for that to be effective. He's going to run to Invochi. He's still alive. Invochi able to keep a futile thing off of him long enough. One for Invochi to get a kill. And also, oh, Invochi gets a second! D-Wheels able to get out with his life. Oh my goodness. Invochi almost kills the enemy carry and goes down. D-Wheels gonna TP back to base. So is Heimer. Heimer may get jumped on by the Pantheon. No. The frenzy of fights breaking out across the map leaves Wainsburg up about 700 gold in this game 3. Not an amazing lead, but definitely a place to build from. We look at the CS, we're looking pretty even. Heimerdinger, whoa, Heimerdinger with a 10 CS lead in the mid, but Draven with a 25 CS lead bottom. But the enemy carry has 3 kills, so that's keeping them pretty even in gold, yeah. These turrets being very annoying. Bottom and mid, but we want them annoying. Causing the any problems is good. But Draven going wild here bottom, just collecting his CS and catching his spinning axes. He's going to go and get a hit on creatures. Ooh, Pantheon down here to jump in on Heimerdinger. With the Annie and the Ignite, that's going to be enough. And the smite, jeez. D-Wheels tanks a bunch bottom. Wacky's getting the shutdown gold. Ult's down Bottom, not quite able to kill the support. She goes really low, though. Pantheon coming bottom. He's going to jump on D-Wheels and take him out immediately. A futile thing is here, so Quacky's in dangerous position. Able to peck away at King Kong Chrono, not able to get the kill. And Voci really wants to follow up. He's going to dash in. A futile thing's going to get some damage on him, gets away. Pantheon's going to TP out. And Mordekaiser's going to push in top. And Waynesburg now with the over 1k lead, gold lead. And pressure going up top. This is great news for them. That Pantheon was able to get work done bottom, but they're going to suffer a little bit for it. And, Mercy Penguin's going to make them pay. Mercy Penguin's going to be able to back off as well. So, good. D-Wheels moving towards creatures. Creatures taking a bunch of damage from Quackies. Can't get away. Oh, finally able to get close enough to the turret that Quackies won't pursue further. D-Wheels dewarding their... dewarding that bush. Creatures half HP. Phoenix also about half HP. Mercy Penguin misses the grab. Able to do some significant damage to creeps though. Ooh, D-Wheels rooted, taking some damage from these enemy turrets. Oh man. Sully putting the hurt on Annie. Ooh. Just able to get her shield up in time. D-Wheels once again headed towards the bush looking for a hook. Good hook or somebody out of position. And Quacky's going to be able to get a kill. In Voci top, they're going to go in on King Kong Chrono. King Kong Chrono, though, a good path out of the bush. Gonna look to turn this around a little bit. Maybe he should have retreated earlier. Thought he could get more done. He just gets shut down. Waynesburg over 2k gold lead now. Feudal Thing comes mid, chasing Sully out. Running up on this wall. Sully getting it grabbed, but Invoci's right there. Oh, the bear is dropped on Sully, and he goes down. Any ult comes out. Mercy Penguin is also here. Getting its scythe. By a futile thing, King Kong Chrono is here. Gonna force Mercy Penguin to back off. Annie gonna use her ult here to do some damage to the mid turret. Tier 1. And blue team actually picking up a Rift Herald, and they're going to slam it into the mid tier 1. Catching them up in gold now, only about a 1k gold lead. Mercy Penguin is there, but low. Ooh, D-Wheels, a nice hit on Creatures. Creatures going to go down. Quacky's probably going to go down too. And D-Wheels at less than half HP against Nami is just going to have to back off. Out here clearing this bush of reward, getting your turret there, which gives some vision. King Kong Chrono just getting damage on that top turret. Wow, mate, is he gonna be able to take down this top of tier one? No, not quite. Voci getting blue buff, farming up. Feudal Thing picking up red. Gonna walk over this wall. Pick up some more farm. CS lead for all lanes for Waynesburg. Just a couple in each lane, a 25, 4 Quackies and a 10 for Mordekaiser. But the kills in the right places for Wesleyan, Ohio Wesleyan. Creatures almost goes down to Invoci. D-Wheel's an excellent hook, but it's not able to stop the scythe from a futile thing, but he's going to go down to Quackies. And Waynesburg takes down 3, only losing Invoci. Means they don't have a smite for this dragon, but with the enemy jungler down, it doesn't matter that much. They're going to take their first dragon in the match. D-Wheel's rotating up towards mid. That's actually maybe kind of dangerous with Annie there. He's kind of low. And D-Wheels goes back. Sully just picking up the farm in mid. Creatures pushing in that bottom wave. Quacky's going to be there in time to collect it and defend his turret. Mommy Nami taking a ton of creatures taking a ton of damage as well. Quacky's taking some damage, but D-Wheel's going to be coming down through river. Quacky's getting jumped on, going to have to flash out. Gonna ult, get some damage, but not any kills. D-Wheels is zoning out for his carry, but taking a bunch of damage in the process. Creech is gonna get the jump in. Just gets out. D-Wheels getting hit by the plant turrets under your tower. It'll land the hook, but the wrong person. Mercy Penguin getting jumped on a little bit. They're fine. D-Wheels just just a couple hundred HP, able to go back. Phoenix almost goes down mid to Sully, but Sully, two-man gank, goes down. Futile Thing and Invoci going toe-to-toe in the jungle. Invoci has to run away. Mercy Penguin finally getting some damage on the top tier 1. Able to equal the Pantheon's damage. May be able to take it. No, not quite. Quacky's coming up from behind, takes the Annie, gets her bear. Mercy Penguin getting ganked. Able to use the ult to get away. Wacky's gonna push mid. Collect some farm here. While Invoci and D-Wheels are gonna go after creatures. Aw. The nice hook from D-Wheels gets deflected away. Invoci gets on top of Creatures, and with D-Wheels there, they should be able to control him enough to get the kill. Top tier 1 goes down, Mercy Penguin taking a bunch of damage, getting dove by the enemy jungler and King Kong Chrono. But the traitorous turret's not interested in actually protecting him. He goes down. Mid. Wayne's are going to take this opportunity to take a 4v2. Gets the hook on Nani.
Red team's turret has been destroyed.
And put the red tier 2. Oof. This Pantheon putting a ton of pressure on top. Almost reminiscent of the pressure that was put on by York in game 2. From the Waynesburg side. And we see the gold difference, very minimal, is Waynesburg only 500 gold ahead, things getting pulled back to even. See Baron Nashor about to spawn, Invoci just getting some damage on the enemy jungler. Mordekaiser starting to push out his lane, farming up. Sully and D-Wheels mid. D-Wheels gonna back up. Creature's coming forward. Gonna take out a turret. Pantheon pushing up bottom. We see Drake about to spawn, and both teams are gonna coalesce as that's the next big objective to fight over. Beautiful Thing gonna take this moment to take up his red buff. And just gonna walk on into this Drake pit and win the river. See any top, and Mordekaiser there. Getting a ton of damage, gets the bear dropped on her. King Kong Chrono getting jumped on by Invochi and D-Wheels. And Feudal Thing is there. Putting a lot of pressure on D-Wheels. He's going to go down to 4. And Annie's able to get away from the Mordekaiser top. They're going to take the bottom tier 1 from Waynesburg. That's going to be Ohio Wesleyan stealing blue buff. They're going to get this next Drake, potentially. The Draven ult was too early to steal it. And with Smite, that's going to be a really hard steal. And Ohio Wesleyan kind of taking just a little bit of a gold lead. Not a big deal. But winning that Drake fight is still pretty big, even though there's not a big gold differential from it. Don't you even pick up his red buff? Feudal Thing picking up his blue. Pits. And Gochi's in the area. He's going to detect them. Looks like both teams are kind of gearing up for a fight. A Feudal Thing's going to walk into Quackies. Quackies takes a bunch of damage from the Nani and King Kong Chrono. He's going to have to run away. Mordekaiser's going to isolate one. They all take a ton of damage. Ward takes down a Feudal Thing, gets jumped on by the rest of Ohio Wesleyan. It's currently a 3 down from Waynesburg for just 2 from Ohio Wesleyan. As they're going to push out mid. But Sully down here getting some turret damage bottom, but he's going to have to back up. They know the Pantheon's backing up, but they don't know where he is. This Nami getting a lot of work done for her team. Not Nami, this is Zyra. Getting a lot of a lot done for her team. Red team's turret. And that's the mid-tier two. Down for Waynesburg. They only have their bottom tier two left. Whereas all the tier twos and they've only lost their mid-tier one from Ohio Wesley. So, almost a 2k gold lead here for Ohio Wesleyan Onyx. Mercy Penguin pushing out top. D-Wheels looking for a hook. D-Wheel's gonna get jumped on. He's gonna die. 5 there. Not quite ready for it. And Ohio Wesleyan just gonna invade the Waynesburg jungle. Knocks Quackies up. Quackies gonna take a ton of damage and drop. Sully gets caught in an ult and takes a ton of damage. He's going to go down, and Vochi is also getting jumped down. He's going to be forced back. Mordekaiser is going to just TP back, and there's pings out for Baron. Ohio Wesleyan's going to move over and look to take Baron. Waynesburg's going to speed back and try and get a steal or a disruption here. But I don't think there's enough time. Top tier one goes down. It's good for Waynesburg, and with Baron falling, Waynesburg's just going to turn around, go get some fun. Drake going to be up in about a minute, and that will be the next big fight. Thresh looking to get some vision for his team. The dewarding coming out of Ohio Wesleyan, pretty effective. And King Kong Chrono going to jump on top of him. Clearing up, but he's going to get jumped on. As three are actually there. Mercy Penguin's going to take him down. That's a big deal. Creech is going to get ulted by Mercy Penguin. Misses the grab, but Creech goes in. D-Wheels is there for when he comes out of the ult. Ah, misses the hook. Mercy Penguin's going to get the shutdown, and Vochi almost picks up Nami. Mercy Penguin's there to get it. Sully gets gone on by the jungler, but Quacky's going to put a ton of damage on him and force him to run away. Nope, not able to pick him up. Mercy Penguin tries to get the grab, but he's a little too sneaky. And Waynesburg, a nice fight there. Still down 2K, but they're going to get this Drake. Barring Annie doing something crazy. Annie gets picked up. She drops her ult. The ult gets dropped. Quacky's once a futile thing, but he's going to get out of there. And that's two Drakes to each side. Quacky's going to pick up blue buff. Futile thing picking up his red buff. We see Invochi top pushing up the lane. They've got to keep that off their tier. They've got to keep the pressure off their tier 3s. See a big invade over towards bottom. Four players from Ohio Wesleyan looking to take that final tier 2 from Waynesburg. And Waynesburg collecting their jungle. Mordekaiser coming down mid. The turret takes a bunch of damage. They start taking turret aggro. Waynesburg coming in, but slowed down by turrets. They're going to get the turret. Waynesburg. In an interesting position. D-Wheel's getting jumped on. He's going to go down. A futile thing getting low. Creech is getting low, and Vochi's in there. He grabs him. Mercy Penguin has ulted somebody. Phoenix going to go down here as well. And that's all but one down for Ohio Wesleyan for just two from Waynesburg, losing D-Wheels and Sully. And they're still chasing the last. That Pantheon's still booking it. And he's going to book it top. Vochi's going to start pushing down mid, and we're going to look to take this tier 2 mid tower while the rest of Ohio Wesleyan is down. And we have a ton of damage here. Maybe able to get some damage on this tier 3 as well, but Pantheon is already back to defend, and they're just going to back off. Good decision. Don't want to get tied up as people are respawning. Ohio Wesleyan starting to push out. D-Wheel sticking around river. Kind of needs somebody around to follow up on his CC. collecting the CS mid. And so kindly delivered to him. Feudal Thing and Pantheon going top. They want this Mordekaiser. Oh, they spotted out in Vucci somehow. Pinged him out, and they're going to go on ward. They see Invochi rotate towards mid. Mercy Penguin getting jumped on. Mordekaiser very survivable with that shield, but he's going to go down to these two. Going to get scythed, and that will be enough. Oh, able to get the shield up. That ult took just long enough that Mercy Penguin got his shield up. Winsward going to take a... A 4v3 mid. Actually, a 3v3. Zinvochi wasn't part of it. Zinvochi hanging out. Kind of split off from his team. Draven rotating bottom. Looking to get some wards up around Drake. And it looks like Baron Nashor is back up. Ooh, and Vochi getting gone on. Blackies is there, discourages Nanny. King Kong Chrono able to get him. The bear is dropped on him. Sully up here defending tier, his top inhibitor from Fertile Thing. Mercy Penguin is there to help. He's going to go for the scythe on Sully. Sully's going to stopwatch out of it. Drake goes down for Ohio Wesleyan, but Sully able to pick up the enemy jungler. That's a third Drake for Ohio Wesleyan. Ohio Wesleyan with about a 3k gold lead. Well, it's the biggest gold lead I think we've seen this game. It's not that substantial when both teams have about 60k. And they see Baron is up. They're going to go D ward. Ooh, D wheels a nice hook. Actually jumps into the Baron pit. They have Baron aggro. D wheels goes down. Oh, the Draven ult able to pick up the Annie. Mercy Penguin going to try and chase him down. Oh, he tried to jump over the wall there. Mommy and Nanny failed it. But D-Wheels, Mordekaiser turned around. And with forcing the Wesleyan players out, Wainsburg going to go for this Baron. They're going to take it easily. That's Baron buff for everyone but D-Wheels. Not only about a 1k gold lead for Ohio Wesleyan. This game remains extremely close as we get into the late game. We see characters getting 5 items, gonna be getting 6 items. It'll be interesting to me to see who's favorite. Quacky's getting jumped on. Does a ton of damage, but doesn't like people actually able to jump on him. Wow, Draven able to pick up the jungler. But Heimer able to pick up, it gets picked up, but Heimer able to take 2. Mercy Penguin is there on the enemy jungler, able to get a ton of damage with D-Wheels providing a lot of CC. D-Wheels, Phoenix is on D-Wheels, he's going to get the bear dropped on him, goes down. Heimerdinger goes down to the Annie, but is able to get her back, and Vochi getting very low, Mercy Penguin. And Waynesburg loses 3, but gets all 5 for Ohio Wesleyan. Mercy Penguin gonna push down mid, and Vochi gonna head bottom, and look to take a tier 1, maybe even a tier 2. And then Vochi's just gonna take this tier 1. because you're going to back off. Everybody will be up in about 5 seconds. And we should see both teams looking to pressure on the map. Looks like Waynesburg wants to send people mid. Drake will be spawning in about a minute and a half. A futile thing. Here, taking his red buff. Ooh, jumps on the Thresh. Not sure that's where he wants to be with Waynesburg looking to respond. And everybody now coalescing around this dragon, around this Drake. Ooh, D-Wheels misses a hook. Waynesburg just kind of using their positioning in the threat of this hook to kind of zone out Ohio Wesleyan from the area, forcing them closer towards mid and away from the actual Drake pit. But Ohio Wesleyan going to take this time. They've got a couple seconds before things respawn and they're going to push out, but that allows Waynesburg to rotate around mid and kind of force Ohio Wesleyan to kind of disperse here. They've gathered four around mid in the river, but a futile thing is going to scythe in Vochi and try and get away. But he's taking a ton of damage. He's able to get out, and Vochi takes a ton of damage, and he also has to run. Draven actually getting taken out in the back. King Kong Chrono comes back. Sully goes down. Mercy Penguin getting jumped on. This fight's looking really bad for Waynesburg. Mercy Penguin goes down. And that's more shutdown gold for Ohio Wesleyan. They're going to pick up their fourth Drake here. Unless Invoji can get a steal, but we'll see what happens. Nope. He's going to get spotted out and taken down. Drake goes down, Vochi goes down, and Ohio Wesleyan going to rotate mid and push out this wave. Seconds until Invochi respawns. But just with D-Wheels and Quackies on defense, anyone who gets hooked could take a ton of damage. Wacky's getting jumped on by King Crab Quino. Sully is there to kind of give him some space. He goes down super low. Mercy Penguin is here. They're going to be relying on him to tank. And to pick up these stupid plant turrets. And Ohio Wesleyan taking out the tier 3 turrets. All inhibitors exposed, taking a bunch of damage. D-Wheels misses a hook. Percy Penguin getting focused down by these turrets. Actually taking a substantial amount of damage from them. Goes down. Quackies is taken out. Invochi goes down. Mercy Penguin is in the middle. Not able to tank. He goes down. Sully and D-Wheels are up here, but they're going to get jumped on by five. D-Wheels tries to run. Bear runs him down. Pantheon lands a spear and finishes him off. And that's all in. Oh, I think that's all inhibitors down. But Ohio Wesleyan is just going to push in these tier 4s and take the Nexus. And this anti-bear just doing a great job of forcing people to stay away. And they jump into Fountain, take out Sully, and take the Nexus. And that will be Ohio Wesleyan taking game 3 and the match.